Hello everyone, welcome to another session of Saurabh Sir classes. Today we are discussing about some multiple choice based question of geography entrance examination. Now let us move to the questions. The first question is, the production of wheat would require, statement A, cool and wet climate during its growing period but hot climate during the ripening period. Statement B, sufficient heat but very little rainfall. Option C, sufficient heat and heavy rainfall. And option D, hot climate during the growing period but cool climate during the ripening period. Means just opposite of the statement A. So, wheat is a crop of temperate grassland. So, I can write here, wheat is a crop of temperate grassland. So, I can say it requires cool climate at sowing and growing and comparatively higher temperature during ripening. Okay, so when we sow the wheat, the climate must be a cooler climate and comparatively higher temperatures needed during the ripening. In India, it is shown during the months of October, November. Means wheat in the month of October and November, wheat is sown and it is harvested during the March, April. In the March, April, it will be harvested from the field. So, in this question, the right answer is option A. That means cool and wet climate during its growing period, but hot climate during the ripening period. Now, let's move to the next question. In this question, they have want to know, during the summer monsoon, the Himalayas have rains on the statement A, southern and western slope, or northern and eastern slope, or northern and western slope, or southern and eastern slopes. During the summer monsoon, the Himalayas get rainfall from Bay of Bengal branch and the branch of monsoon winds which comes from the southeasterly direction. Or we can say the Himalayas are prone to abundant rainfall and flooding episodes during the summer monsoon, particularly over south facing slopes. Are in the Gangetic Plains of India, which I said the Bay of Bengal, the agricultural importance of this rainfall is also substantial as the region's population depends greatly on the monsoon rains. So, in this question, the answer is D. The answer is D, southern and eastern slopes. Now, let's move to the next question. The most leading port of India in terms of traffic handling. There's four options. One is Mumbai, second is Kolkata, third Kandla, and four, the Chennai. The Mumbai port, along with which name is the Jawaharlal Nehru port, is the most busiest and the largest port of India which handles the largest traffic volume. So in this question, the answer is A. It also known as Jawaharlal Nehru port, as well as it is the most busiest post in the country, as well as it's also the largest port. You can remember all those things in India. But if they ask which port of India is largest in terms of cargo handling, that time it was Paradip, which is the in terms of cargo handling, which is the largest port, and the second largest port is Visakhapatnam. Hope this video will be helpful for your preparation. Thanks for watching us.